Good evening, everyone. Are you ready? Hallelujah. Are you ready? I am in expectation for whatever the Holy Spirit wants to do tonight. And if you can just all stand on your feet, and we're just going to open up our hearts on tonight for whatever God wants to do. Holy Spirit, we welcome you. We welcome you, Lord, into this place, into this atmosphere, into our hearts, into our very souls. We welcome your Holy Spirit. You are welcome to do whatever you want to do. We pour out in your presence on tonight. We pour out, we empty out, God, and we want you to fill us up. Fill us up until it's an overflow of your power, of your strength. Oh, God, we need you. We invite you, Lord. We invite you in, Lord. Oh, God, change our minds. Oh, God, send us into the right path that we need to go in. And we invite you. We love on you. We crown you King. We crown you Lord. You're our Savior. You're our of our souls, and we welcome you. We love on you tonight. We love on you this entire weekend. We want to experience you in a way we've never experienced you before. We want you to touch us and dwell with us, Lord. Dwell with us, Holy Spirit. We invite you in. We invite you in. We open up tonight. We open up tonight. We open up tonight. You, Lord, we invite you, Lord. We want to be changed. We want to be renewed. We want our minds to be changed on tonight. We want our thoughts to be filtered out on tonight. We want a new heart. Create in us a new heart, oh God, and renew the right spirit within us, Lord. Cleanse us on tonight. Cleanse us, Lord. Oh God, until we're made all over again. Oh God, made in your likeness and in your image, oh Lord, prepare for us to do whatever you have designed for us to do. And we glorify you and we give you praise on tonight in Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah.
Come on, lift up your voice tonight. Rejoice in the Lord tonight. I mean, it's ready to dance in his river tonight. Hallelujah. Come on, I invite you all, ladies, to come up front. Come on, come on up front. Let's worship the Lord. Let's praise him today because he's worthy of all our praise. Hallelujah.
There is a fountain that drowns sorrows. There is an ocean deeper than fear. The tide is rising, rising.
There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing. The heart of God, the blood of heaven crashing over us. The tide is rising, rising.
There is a river, the goodness flows. There is a fountain that drowns sorrows. There is an ocean deeper than fear. The tide is rising.
There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God, the blood of heaven
want you to lay your hands on your belly. You're going to sing this, spring up, oh well. Spring up, oh well. Come on. Break open prison doors. Set all the captives free. Come on. Spring up, oh well.
Name by which we're saved, Jesus.
is what I want you to do. The party says the king is coming in. The king is coming in. We lift up a shout to shake the skies. You think you can lift up a shout to shake the skies? Up a shout. I want you to lift it up. All right? Come on. Lift up your heads, you ancient gates. We lift it up, you ancient doors. The king is coming in. The king is coming in. All right, get ready. Hey. We lift up a shout to shake the skies. We lift up a cry. We glorify. The king is coming in. The king is coming in.
Thank you.
You're the king of my heart. We declare tonight, we say you are our everything, God. Hey, you're the king of my heart. And you are good, you are good. You're so, so good. So, so good. We love to worship. We love to love you, God. Lord, we declare tonight that you are the king of our heart. Hey, Lord Jesus, come take a seat on our heart tonight.
Let the king of my heart be the mountain where I run. Fountain I drink from, oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the shadow where I hide. Ransom for my life, oh, he is my song. For you are good, 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 Lord. You are good, good,
This is a new day. This is a new year. We just started a new year. Tell me what's going to happen today at the women's conference. She saw a vision of the open book, which is your destiny. And she said she saw the Lord, well, actually me and her, she saw us passing out the book to each lady as they come up on the platform like we were passing out a diploma. Okay. But also in the vision, she said she saw in the corner a pile of shoes. Every kind of shoe that you can think of. Dress shoes, black shoes, tennis shoes, red shoes. What's your shoes? But she said, for some reason, we knew who to give the books to. And everybody was assigned a pair of shoes. But on the cover of this book was your pair of shoes. So God says, through your worship, your books are being opened to Him. And He's declaring a decree to you that this is your destiny. walk out your destiny. Shoes on.
Walking into my destiny. I'm walking into my destiny. I'm walking into my destiny, and it's leading me to victory. I'm walking into my destiny. It's leading me to victory. Walking into my destiny. Walking into my destiny.
Walking in, walking in.
Walking into my destiny. Walking into my destiny.
Okay, the Lord is showing me that there's women in this room that feel like they have no destiny. But they're not worthy. God says you're worthy because I died and that made you worthy.
Hey!
So you literally need to take shoes and put them on your feet. Come on, act like you're putting shoes on your feet. If you don't think you have a destiny, then you are so, so mistaken. Everybody has a destiny. God had the perfect plan and the perfect purpose before you were even formed in your mama's womb. You are worthy. You are worthy. So put on your shoes. You are worthy. You are worthy. Come on, whoever you are, put your shoes on. You are worthy to walk in your destiny. Come on, push your shoes on.
For a minute.
We lift you up. 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 We
You know, can you hear me? Wait, hold on. Praise the Lord. Can you hear me out there? Hallelujah. I'm so happy to be in this place. In Glen Burnie, Maryland on Wednesday night. Amen. In the glory of God. Hallelujah. With such anointed worshipers. Amen. But listen, while I was worshiping in my seat right there, I could almost barely hold myself together. Pastor Tracy said, "You're not about to go yet, are you?" I said, "Oh, Lord, I was scratching to get up here." You know, I heard the Holy Spirit say that there is ceiling-breaking power in this place tonight. Ceiling-breaking power in this place tonight. I want to explain what that is to you, because sometimes, come on, we go to a comfortable place. Listen, I want everybody's attention right here. I don't play games. I'm ready to see the glory. Amen. I didn't come all the way from South Louisiana to have a good service. I have good services, come on, right where I live. But I came here right now tonight to see the glory of the Almighty God. So he said this. He said, "Heather, there is," that's my name, "there is ceiling breaking power in this room right now. But you're going to have to worship past your own capacity." I said, "You're going to have to worship past your own capacity." That means you're going to have to do what does not feel comfortable for you to do. Oh, I didn't get as many amens and hallelujahs right there. I said, "You're going to have to do what feels unusual to you, but not for you, for him." And so, listen, Joseph, this is what I heard the Holy Ghost say. He said, "You know, they're singing about my goodness, and that has ceiling breaking power." I said, "When you sing about the goodness of God, it has ceiling breaking power." You know what that means? I'm about to define this. That means earth can't hold you. I said, "Earth can't hold you." I said, "Earth can't hold you." Let me tell you something. Let me tell you, we're about to worship. I see y'all are like, you know, y'all are like runners. Y'all at the starting line. Y'all ready to go. But let me tell you something about this. Listen, this is going to give you revelation, and revelation brings you breakthrough. I said, "This is going to give you revelation, and revelation gives you breakthrough." Say it with me. This will give me revelation, and revelation will bring breakthrough. Hallelujah. So if earth can't hold you, let me tell you something about your mess. Somebody say, "Tell me about my mess."
Tell me about my mess.
Let me tell you about your mess. Listen to me. God does, I'm Cajun, so I'm trying to hold back the Cajunese. God don't come down in the middle of your mess. I know, you know, when we're real nice and lazy, that's how we want it to be. When we're lazy, we want God to come down and rescue us. Ooh, Jesus. Now, in Isaiah 64 and verse 1, he said, "I'll rend the heavens." But he rend the heavens whenever he came in the form of Jesus. Ooh, Father God. Is this too deep for the first night? Praise the Lord. Somebody say, "Earth can't hold me." Let his will be done in the earth as it is in heaven. How does that happen? Come on, that means you're going to leave this place and your families are going to be different. Your children are going to be different. Your husbands are going to be different. Your finances are going to be different. Come on. wish somebody in here would actually believe that. What are the chances of me getting more of myself in a monitor? All right, so about your mess, he'll never come down to your mess. But what happens is that when you begin to worship him, he'll break the ceiling open. And all of a sudden, while you're lifting him up, praise the Lord, thank you for that. While you're lifting him up, come on, he's going to lift you up. Because he said, draw near unto me and I will draw near unto you. And next thing you know, that mountain, come on, looks like it says in Zechariah chapter 4 and verse 6. What was a mountain has become a flat plateau before me. You know, I fly a lot of places. And if you fly over the Grand Canyon, it doesn't look as big as it looks in person. What seems insurmountable here on earth is not insurmountable where you truly exist. I said where you truly exist. I said where Jesus is Lord. I said where you truly exist. You see, if we could get just a few folks with a kingdom, a heavenly mindset, come on, your situation is going to change. I said your situation is going to change. And earth won't be able to hold you. But what will happen is, come on, he's going to lift you up out of that thing. He's going to lift you up out of that mess. And you're going to find yourself at the throne. Come on. And he's going to impart some revelation unto you, some life-giving, life-changing power. Praise the Lord. But earth can't hold you. So while we were singing about the goodness of the whole of God, the Holy Spirit reminded me that everywhere goodness goes, mercy flows. I said everywhere goodness goes, mercy flows. Now, I was reminded while we were worshiping about Job, good old Job. Anybody ever feel like Job up in here? Come on. We ain't denying reality. We just about to build a bridge over it. So old Job, you know, at the beginning, if you read the whole book of Job, God starts asking Job some questions. And he's telling Job, whenever you can answer these questions, I'm going to lift you up out your mess. Anybody have some adversity in here? Come on, I know what this church is called to do in this city, and I know that there is great adversity. But I know that right there in the middle of adversity, God is ready to outpour some mercy and change everything. He'll change everything. Drummer, you like to use the kick drum? I like the kick drum. All right. So Job, listen to this. Get this. Some revelation. Come on. When you get some revelation, earth can't hold you. One revelation is enough to make you mess around and see your whole family change. To see this whole city set ablaze. We'll get people pouring in from off the street. Praise the Lord. Y'all better be ready. So here's old Job. Don't sit down on me now. Come on, in our church, we barely sit down. I almost preach stand. Everybody stands up. So I was just messing around. You can sit down if you need to. So, can y'all hear me over there in the back? I want to make sure y'all hear me, because you know what? Praise the Lord. You get this revelation. Come on, you barely need somebody to pray with you at the end of the service. You mess around and get it at the beginning, everything else will just be extra. So here, Job, all the way through Job, God is asking Job questions. Questions like, Job, who created what's attacking you right now? Job, go read it. I ain't making this stuff up. Job, who put the hook in Leviathan's mouth, Job? Oh, y'all don't even know about Leviathan. Job, who told the sea to stop right here? Job, who told the sun when to shine and the moon when to come out? Theologians believe it took old Job 9 months to get the answer. Some of y'all, it's taken 19 years, 29 years, 40 years, but somebody say, tonight is my night. You better say it like you believe it. So it was about in chapter 40, I believe. Here comes Job, and God's getting ready to ask him the same questions again. Come on, don't you know God is telling you right now that thing that's attacking you? He's saying, who do you think I bruised my heel on? So, about chapter 40, Job begins to wake up. Am I all right here, Pastor Tracy? Job begins to wake up, and he has a revelation of something. He has a revelation of God's sovereignty, and he has a revelation of God's goodness. That what was taken by the enemy will also be restored double. Come on, I said, Pastor Tracy, that what's been taken has to be restored double. Come on, but it ain't found in a broken heart. Come on, you better get this. Don't get the first part and miss the second. I know I ain't supposed to preach tonight, but we just gonna break the ceiling. That's it. That's all I'm doing. So, here comes Job. And God says, Job. And Job says, hold up, wait a minute. That's my own translation. Job said, I'm done with the tears. I'm done with the ashes. I'm done with the begging, and I'm done with the pleading. He said, you ask me some questions, and I want you to let me answer them. And he began to answer God. And he said this. This is chapter 42. It took him to chapter 42. Come on. And then you can get this in 1 second tonight. Just 1 second. And there will be freedom that will blow your mind. You will have life and life to the full. Come on, when the enemy starts attacking, I like to go and read old Job. And I say, devil, it ain't gonna take me no 42 chapters. It ain't gonna take me no 9 months. We got the answers to this test. It's open book. It says, then Job answered. This is verses 1 through 6. Then Job answered and said, I know that you can do everything. Oh, praise the Lord. You know we like to say it, but right now I'm talking about some revelation. I'm talking about some revelation that'll say, God, I know you can do everything. Come on. In the Hebrew, that literally means everything. Every little thing. He said, I know that you can do everything and that no purpose of yours can be withheld from you. You asked, who is this who hides counsel without knowledge? You know what God was saying right there? I never ask a question I didn't already give the answer to. Come on, I wish you'd get it. I never ask a question that I didn't already give the answer to. He said, therefore, I have uttered what I did not understand, things too wonderful for me which I did not know. Listen, please, and let me speak. You said I will question you, and you shall answer me. I have heard of you by the hearing of the ear. Listen right here. Listen to this. Get this right here. This is where revelation steps in. I have heard of you by the hearing of the ear, but now my eyes see you. That's the difference in tonight. That's the difference in this meeting. This women's conference, come on, has been prayed over, believed in, come on, and the devil has done everything he can. I said he has done everything he can to stop what God is going to do, but don't you dare let him. I don't believe I'm in a room full of wimps and cowards. Come on, you ought to let the devil know you messed with the wrong one. And I know. Listen. And I know that not one purpose of God can be withheld. No matter what. Listen, he said this, but now my eyes see you. Therefore, I repent in dust and ashes. Come on, I ain't begging. I ain't repenting for all the things I might have done. I'm just simply repenting for not having revelation of your goodness and your mercy towards me. Oh, glory to God. So I believe right there, right there in the where you are, right in the middle of that thing, right in the middle of that adversity. Come on, God is getting ready to pour out some mercy in this place. I said he's getting ready to pour out some mercy. Come on, so we're going to say it again. And all of a sudden, we're going to lift up. Come on, and earth can't hold you. Earth can't hold you. You ready? Come on, prophesy. Prophesy on those drums.
You are good.
You're never gonna let
you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We glorify you, Father. We glorify you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You're high and lifted up. You're high and lifted up. We magnify you, Lord. We magnify you. The name above every name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we love you. We honor you tonight. And our hearts are ready for the word. Our hearts are ready for revelation that brings great breakthrough. In the name of Jesus, we submit ourselves to you. We surrender to you. We recognize and we honor you with great expectation. We sit on the edge of our seats ready, ready to know a mystery about you, to be changed by you, and to be who we have been called to be for you. And we declare that you are our shepherd, and we never lack. We never lack for wisdom, revelation, ability, opportunity, money. We never lack. Surely goodness and mercy follow us all the days of our lives. In Jesus' name. Come on, if you're in agreement with that, say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, why don't you turn around and greet a few people around you? Thank you, Jesus.